He joins us in the studio today. Thank you for coming to the show, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Karen, for inviting me. First of all,
it's good that you came because are you even a serious contender? Some of them told me you don't campaign in Quezon City. So people see only Joy Belmonte and Bing Bong as the serious contenders.
Well, I do my campaigns in Quezon City, but without fanfare, no? I go to the different barangays and talk to the people and really discuss with them their problems. And that's how I do it, because when I was then congressman, I really listened to what the people need.
Okay, why not run for Congress again?
Well,
is it your last term?
No, no.
Okay,
it's just that I could do more for the city and continue what my father has started before for the city. Like, for example, in the business side of the city, when my father was then mayor, he made the city a business-friendly city. And I want that to be a business-friendly city again now.
And you don't think that under the Belmonte-Bautista team that had happened?
Well, the people, the business sector have been talking about it. And sabi nila na there was a big difference from the time my father was then mayor. It was much more easier to enter or to renew their businesses in Quezon City than now. Now they're really having a hard time to do all these things.
Okay. Now, a survey's come out wherein you have Joy Belmonte leading at, I think, more than 60%. Bing Bong at number two. And in that survey, it puts you in a very, in other words, it's almost a miracle if you would win. Ganun tipo yung survey na yon.
Yes.
Do you believe it?
Well, now, well, because of the survey, a lot of people still don't know that I was running for mayor. And okay. Others were told that I backed out from running for the mayorship. But now, because they know already that I'm running, they have a choice already of whom to vote for Quezon City.
Okay, what's your strategy? What's your strategy to beat Joy Belmonte?
Well, my strategy is really to stay in touch with the people.
Uh-oh.
The silent majority of Quezon City have been telling me ever since before I decided to run for the mayorship of Quezon City that they're having a hard time in Quezon City. And I said, well, that's what I will do. I will do what the people need for Quezon City. Like, for example, the working class now of Quezon City, all those who have jobs in Quezon City, I will order the companies to transfer them to the company where they are working at nearest to where they live so that they will save time in traveling, going to work and coming home from work. That is one of the problems now of all working class of Quezon City. Ang sabi nila, they spend about 6 hours, 3 hours in the morning, 3 hours.
So you don't want them to go to Quezon City to work?
No, we will bring them all back to Quezon City. Even those who are working outside of, mostly those who are working outside of Quezon City, I will have them transferred to the nearest branch of their company where they live. So that they will be able to save on their travel time.
Okay.
And that will solve the problem in traffic, because lesser people traveling, going to work and coming home, that will ease the traffic in Quezon City alone.
Okay, what would you do in terms of the very controversial ordinance? Well, now it's the real estate. They call it the real estate tax, which Joy Belmonte says no. It is the fair market value assessment of the properties in Quezon City.
Yeah.
What would you do if you are mayor? Because the local council passed that. It has not been implemented, but it's now in effect a law within the city.
Yeah.
Would you implement it?
No, I think we have to work out on trying to see what will be best for the city. Like now they passed a suspension in that increase of the realty property tax. So they were able to do that just for this year, 2019. And maybe before 2020, the council could study again if that is really needed. You know, that increase is really needed for the city. It says in the local government code that if you have enough to be able to deliver the basic services for the people, then you don't have to increase taxes. Mm-hmm. And that's, well, that's it.
But do you have enough? I mean, Bingbong Crisologo's advocacy is to improve on health.
Yes.
He says he wants to, I mean, he has major, big promises of putting more on health at the dialysis center. What is yours?
Well, my program on health, especially for the senior citizens, is I will give their maintenance, monthly maintenance medicine for free. Because...
And how many would they be?
Well, that would be... now the citizens of senior citizens of Quezon City is more than 1,000. But if we may be able to address giving them those maintenance medicine monthly, it will help the whole family because, alam niyo, Karen, the one who are buying those medicines are their children.
Yeah.
And their children, because their children, but also their own families, sabi nga nila sa akin, sabi niya, alam niyo po, if that burden will be removed from them, then they will be able to save the money that they are spending for their parents monthly and use it for else for their family. Sabi nga nila, hindi naman nagkakasakit yung anak nila ng every month. Maswerte na raw na magkasakit yung anak nila ng 6 months or a year. Then that will be a big help. It will help the whole family, not only the senior citizens, but the whole family.
What would you do considering that Quezon City has over 120,000 informal settlers?
Well, I've been chairman of Upland Bayanihan before when my father was then mayor. And this is one wherein we were able to address the problem, especially in my district, that informal settlers are really in that huge numbers. But if there is a housing project, and this housing project will be done on a bayanihan basis, then we will be able to lower the cost because there will be no cost sa labor and it will just be the materials that will be put in the cost of the housing. Then it will be more affordable for the people. And the people will really treasure because they will be part of it in building these houses. Mm-hmm. And
What would you do? Would it be on site in city relocation?
In city relocation. Because
have you found land?
Yes, we have already.
Where?
In the Payates area.
Okay.
Because there are still areas in the Payates where we can build the houses.
Okay.
And to tell the viewers that when I was then the chairman of Upland Bayanihan and chairman of my foundation, Puso Makabayan Foundation, the first project of Habitat for Humanities in the country was in Quezon City.
Yeah.
And we were happy because a lot helped in building the houses, including the beneficiaries of the houses built their own houses. Now they're happy, their life changed, their family changed, and can you imagine they're only paying 200 pesos a month for a decent house that they were proud of.
Yeah. Why did you choose? I mean, you have Joy Belmonte choosing Gian Soto as the vice mayor.
Yes.
Bingbong choosing Jopet Season as his vice mayor. You chose Roderick Paulate, although he is experienced.
Yeah.
He faces graft charges for alleged ghost employees within the city.
Yeah.
So why would you choose, or why did you choose Roderick Paulate?
Well, with his programs.
Yeah.
When he was his counselor.
So you don't believe the charges of ghost employees?
No, actually, he should answer for that. No? And I told him that I will stay away from it and let him be the one to answer for those charges. But what is important is that we can work together because our programs are for the people. And the people really need these programs.
But then in getting him as your partner, it means you don't believe the charges.
Well, I don't believe because I think he has to answer for that. No, but right now, as I believe, that he's still a candidate, he's my party mate, and he is still running.
So you believe he's innocent?
I think, yes.
Okay, all right. Okay, so clearly you don't believe, that's what I was trying to get at, you believe he has a clean track record.
Yeah, and he should answer for it. No? That's what I was telling him.
So what platform are you both running on?
Well, our platform is really for the people, like what he has done when he's as councilor. For pro people, eh. Lahat ng projects niya, it's the same with what I want for the people of Quezon City. Yeah.
So does this mean Joy and Bingbong are not pro people? What is your edge over them?
No, I think, they have their own priorities now. And they do believe that in their priorities, that's what is best for the people of Quezon City. But in my administration, I do believe that I can do what I feel that the people really need.
But what would be the first change in Quezon City if you win as mayor?
Well, the first change is what I said. You know, the working class, transfer them to the nearest branch to where they live so that gumigiginhawa ang kanilang buhay, no? You know, going to work every day, spending 6 hours, reduce it to an hour. Yeah.
But that's not a social service thing. That's more of like a discussion with business owners.
Well, if we will be able to implement that in Quezon City, then the people of Quezon City will feel the difference immediately. I don't have to.
Can you make that? You can. You need a law for that.
Yes.
So you need a council.
Yes.
Yeah, but as mayor, what would you first do without the without, let's say, the action of the council?
Without the action.
Yeah, because I'm imagining what you said, like ABS-CBN is based in Quezon City.
Yes.
You're asking everybody who lives in Quezon City to be reporting to ABS Quezon City.
No, to transfer them to the nearest branch to where they live.
Yeah, but to where they live.
Yes, to where they live.
So let's say if they live in Bulacan, you're ordering ABS, for example, no, to assign them in Bulacan.
Well,
parang ganon.
Hindi naman ganon. Give priorities to the residents of Quezon City. Like, for example, you're a gasoline boy and you're working in this gasoline station. If there's a branch nearest to where you live, then I'll have you transferred to that branch to where you live, because so that you can save on transportation costs.
And even if it's not Quezon City?
No, within, it should be in Quezon
with,
City.
Only within, okay.
Within Quezon
Other
City.
Than that, what would be your first act?
And my first act also would be those who have no jobs. I will make them go, not elsewhere to look for jobs, but go to the city hall. Why? It's because I will not require yung requirements, no requirements policy while looking for a job. So the city hall will be tasked to talk to the establishments and the companies within Quezon City and to submit all their vacant positions in their companies so that the people will not go elsewhere spending so much, you know.
So a job fair.
Not really a jobs fair, but it will be permanent. They will just go to the city hall because I will implement the no requirement policy.
Uh-oh.
And the requirement will come in when they are hired so that they have money to pay, where to get the money to pay for the requirement.
What do you think was the failure of Herbert Bautista's leadership?
Well, I don't think he has failed, though, with the
Or let's
leadership.
Say, let's change the word. What didn't he prioritize in that you would?
Well, he concentrated on what he thought was best for the city.
Which was?
Like infrastructures, you know, roads and all these infrastructure projects. And that's what he believes in his that's his priorities.
So you would lessen, allotment for infra?
Well, I will ask the people on what they want. What they want and what they need. Because my father told me before, sabi niya, pag nabigyan ka ng pagkakataon na para, you know, maglingkod sa tao, sabi niya sa akin, huwag mong gawin yung gusto mo. Pakinggan mo yung sinasabi ng tao. At yun ang trabawin mo at gawin mo ang proyekto para hindi masayang ang pondo ng gobyerno.
I'm curious on another note, no? Is Aramina going to campaign for you?
Yes, she is.
Okay.
Yes.
And other stars, because I mean, if Roderick Paulate is there, then Ara.
Well, maybe other stars will help in the campaign, but definitely Ara is campaigning for me.
Okay, last words, sir. Why should they choose you, the residents in Quezon City, over Joy and Bingbong?
By my administration will be pro-people. And as I said, I want the people to feel, you know, that their lives have improved. And that is what I've done when I was then congressman of Quezon City. That my district has 85% informal settlers in my district then. And we were able to improve the lives of these people by giving them housing, and this project of mine, which I use also my foundation for the CMP project.
Yeah.
Well, I called it Shop Mathay Pabahay.
Yeah.
Shop Mathay Pabahay. And they really appreciated what I have done. Sabi nga nila, napaka-imposible nangyari.
Uh-oh.
And through me, and through their help, through the Bayanihan system, which we have done, and when I was then congressman, then I think we will be able to do it on a citywide basis.
Okay. You said you can help more as mayor. Who is taking over? I mean, is anyone in the family running for Congress in your place?
No one. No one.
So you just gave it up?
Yes, it's only me that's running for the mayorship of Quezon.
No, I meant for Congress, because
no one.
Is anyone taking over?
No one. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
All right. On that note, Chuck Mathay, thank you, sir,
thank
for coming
so
to the show.
Karen,
thank
for
you
inviting me.